So yesterday we unboxed the Honor 20 and today we have the Honor 20i. So you guys know what I'm gonna do. We have the blue Honor box here with a 20i image up top and some branding to the sides. Opening it up, the first thing inside is the Honor 20i itself. Taking it out of the plastic wrap, we have the Phantom Blue variant here, peeling off the sticker to the back, and Honor these days seems to be doing a really good job with these gradient design backs. Anyway, let me set the phone aside for a bit. The next thing inside the box is the SIM ejector. And then we have some documentation, a soft case. Now it's worth noting that we didn't get one with the Honor 20s, and it's good to see Honor include that here with a lower priced offering nonetheless. I think it is all the more important here since the back's plastic and plastic does tend to pick up scratches easier. We then have a 10 watt charger and finally a micro USB cable. Now that is disappointing. Almost everyone, even Samsung, has moved on to Type-C and are providing some sort of fast charging, but Honor seems to be still stuck in the past with micro USB. So anyway, before we move on and take a closer look at the 20i, if you've been liking what you've been seeing so far, please subscribe, turn on notifications by hitting that bell icon. Also, K20, K20 Pro giveaway, it's currently running on the channel, so go ahead, link in the description below. Ash here, you're watching C4E Tech. Now coming back to the Honor 20i, due to all that plastic, this is a pretty lightweight phone weighing in at just 165 grams. It is also pretty sleek at under 8mm thick. That said, this is good quality plastic and it has a very eye-catchy color scheme here on the back. It's the traditional Honor gradient finish with the blues and the purples, looks gorgeous and it's definitely gonna turn a few heads. Now we have the AI camera branding here and this is a triple camera setup. So let's actually start with this. We have a 24 megapixel primary shooter with a f1.8 lens. The shots here look good. We have a good amount of detail and the colors too are okay. They are a little lacking with regards to dynamic range, initial impressions. We do have a separate HDR mode though. Kinda wish they had auto HDR. What is it, 2015? Now, the Honor 20i also has a dedicated night mode and it seems to improve the low light shots quite a bit. You can see the images definitely are sharper with it turned on. The secondary camera, it's an 8 megapixel ultrawide and it does fairly okay with regards to detail. And the final shooter, it's a depth sensor. Now since we are on the subject of cameras, we have a 32 megapixel selfie camera and it does well. There's ample detail and the resulting selfies do look quite good. Now beneath the selfie camera that's tucked into this tiny notch, we have a 6.21 inch screen. It's not AMOLED but it's still a display that looks nice. It's got a full HD plus resolution, exhibits natural colors and impressive viewing angles. So pretty good when it comes to media consumption. Now talking about media consumption, one thing that the 20i has that even the 20 lacks, it's the headphone jack. So that is a nice little touch there. But then right next to that headphone jack happens to be the micro USB port. And like I said at the start of the video, I am not a big fan of that. Also along the bottom edge, we have the primary mic and the speaker. We have the power and volume keys to the right. The secondary mic and hybrid slot can be found up top. So yeah, micro SD is also something that the 20i has, the 20 doesn't. Well, to the left, that's left clean, pun intended. As far as the internals go, we still have the Kirin 710. It's pretty snappy when it comes to day-to-day tasks, especially when you throw in the fact that there's 4 gigs of RAM, 128 gigs of onboard storage, not to mention EMUI 9 built on top of Android 9 Pie. That's what it's running on. That's pretty slick. But returning to that Kirin 710 for a moment, at this point, it is a year old chip. And while it's comparable to the 636 or the 660, given more and more devices these days are on the Snapdragon 710 or even the 675, the Kirin 710 is not going to be able to really keep up, at least not with regards to the GPU. So while day-to-day user experience might be fine, I don't see this one being first choice, at least for gamers or anyone who wants to push their phones really hard on a day-to-day basis. Now, on the battery side of things, we have a 3200 milliamp hour battery in here. And based on track record, that should be quite decent. Again, I'm gonna have to test it more before I draw conclusions in the full review. From a charging perspective, things are limited to 10 watts. Now, that is kind of a weird decision. Keep in mind the competition here. Realme has VOOC 3.0. Redmi offers only 10 watts. Yes, that is out of the box, but there is support for QC4 if you want it. Even Samsung kind of understands the value. They're throwing in 15 watts in the box. So this is another area where I feel Honor has kind of fallen behind a bit. So basically, what this device has going for it is the looks. That triple camera is set up to the back, and yes, that selfie shooter as well. So how good are these cameras? Is it better than the Redmi Note 7 Pro? Well, that is something we would have to test out. So would you guys want to see a comparison? Well, before we really get into that, here's a bit of a teaser. Let's do a quick little blind test. Now, one of these pictures is the Redmi Note 7 Pro, the other is shot with the 20i. Which one do you think is better, A or B? Leave a comment below, so go on, let me see what you think. Here's another one. So here's the final one. So have you left a comment? Now here's the reveal. A was the Redmi Note 7 Pro, B was the Honor 20i. Which one did you like more again? Let me know in the comments below. Finally, coming to the pricing, considering how murky the future of Huawei and Honor by extension is, and taking into account the stiff competition that we're facing in the 10 to 15K segment right now, I would expect Honor to be aggressive here with the pricing. Now, we don't have any official confirmation yet, but if I were Honor, I would probably price the Honor 20i somewhere between the Note 7 and the Note 7 Pro. I think for the 20i to be a success, it needs to be priced somewhere around 12,000 rupees. And I do understand a 128GB variant can't be priced there, so maybe have a lower storage variant, a 64GB variant at that price, because 128 as a base and asking 15-16K for it, I really don't see that cutting it. But then again, these are just my initial thoughts. What do you think should be a reasonable price for this phone? Let me know in the comments below. And with that, we get to the end of this video. Thumbs up, thumbs down based on whatever you felt about it. Do you want to see a full review of it? Let me know again in the comments. And also subscribe, turn on notifications by hitting that bell icon if you haven't yet. K20, K20 Pro giveaway. Link in the description. Check that out if you haven't. So that's about it for the video. Thanks a lot for watching. Till next time, my name's Ash. You've been watching C4 Retech, and I'm signing off for now. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.